Hi friends, let us discuss RL circuit today. This is the circuit for DC source connected to two resistors, but in RL circuit inductor is involved. So if inductor is involved, AC source is appropriate compared to DC source, as DC source has no impact on inductance. So let me change this DC source to AC first. For that one, I need to click Simulink library, and this is the Simulink library where we can see in SimPower systems I have electrical sources. I have AC source, so let me take that AC source here and remove the DC source first. And this is AC source, so I will name it as voltage V only. After that, let's give the value. So please connect. So I have connected AC source here, and it is connected to one resistor, and the other thing is inductor. So simply you can change like this inductor, and as this is AC source is involved in it, here instead of continuous we need to select discrete, so that the other equipments will work properly. And for display, I need to always displays the instantaneous value, but for AC we need RMS value instead of instantaneous value. So I need to connect an RMS block here. So please click RMS block in Simulink library so that we can get an RMS block here. That's it. And try to right click on this and drag and drop here so that you will get one more RMS block. But before going to that, I need to change this to running RMS so that it will run properly. And I need to click here, I need to click here, drag and drop here. That's it. That's all. Now this is the complete RL circuit. Now I need to give the values. This is the simple vector representation or phasor representation, phasor diagram of RL series circuit. Here current I is constant, so I have taken I as the reference. As we know that the voltage across the resistance and the current passing through the resistance are in phase to each other, so I have drawn VR like this. And in an inductor, current lags the voltage, so the voltage across the inductance is leading the current by 90 degrees. So I have drawn like this. This is VL. Now the resultant of VR and VL will give us voltage V, and theta is the angle between voltage V and current I. So this is the total narration of RL series circuit. So according to vector algebra, I can say that V square is equal to VR square plus VL square. Okay, according to Pythagoras theorem. So this is the case. But now we know that V is equal to IZ, VR is equal to IR, VL is equal to IXL, and Z square is equal to, where Z is the impedance, and Z square is equal to R square plus XL square. Now let us consider current I is equal to 1 ampere for convenience. Therefore V is equal to Z. In this equation we can substitute I is equal to 1 so that V is equal to Z. If peak value of the AC source is 100 volt, the RMS value will become 70.7 volt. If the angle between voltage and current is 60 degree, cos theta would be R by Z, which implies cos 60 is 1 by 2, which is equal to R by 7.7, which implies R is equal to 35.35 volt. So in this way, we obtain R value, resistance value. And coming to XL, XL is equal to square root of Z square minus R square, which is equal to, which comes to 61.23 ohm. Now XL is equal to 2 pi FL, This we already know this. And where f is pi is 3.14 and f is 50 hertz, so it comes around 314.16 capital L. Therefore, the L is equal to 195 millihenry. So in this way, we have assumed something and we got something. So we have assumed current I is equal to 1 ampere and voltage applied is equal to 100 volt peak or RMS 7.7 volt, and the angle between voltage and current is 60 degree. These are our assumptions, and we obtained our resistance R is equal to 35.35 ohm and L is equal to 195 millihenry. So finally, these are my values. I need to keep these values. V maximum Vm or V peak is equal to 100 volt. Current I is equal to 1 ampere. R is equal to 35.35 ohm. L is equal to 195 millihenry. So let us keep all these values in the circuit. This is 100 and frequency should be 50. Apply. Okay. And the resistance should be 35.35 ohm. And inductance should be 195 millihenry. We can call into star 10 to the power, e power minus 3. Apply. Okay. So this is the resistance 35.35, and this is the inductance value is 195 millihenry, and this is the voltage, and this value is 70.7. I have given RMS value here, 70.70. now I like to run this simulation so that I will get something. Yeah, it is showing error. Yes, we may not, no need of this star. So let me remove the same, apply and okay, so that it may come up. Yes, it is taking time, but still we can see the values. The values are around 70.7 only, and the current value is 1 ampere. And that third one is, let me see the third one. So the third one is voltage across the resistance, that comes around 35.35 only, and this one is around 61.23. okay, let us wait up to till it will complete. Otherwise, let me stop the simulation, and I like to change to maybe 1 second also. I have changed the simulation time to 1 second so that the thing will be faster. Has I reduced the time from 4 second to 1 second? Yeah, the simulation has been done quickly. This is 70.7 as we have expected, around 70.7, and this is 1 ampere around, and 35.35, 61.25. So these are the values we have obtained by this simulation. So let me see the waveforms also. Yeah, these are the waveforms. Yes, these are the waveforms we have obtained. Let us see what exactly these values are. Yes, okay, let me see it from, I think only 2 cycles are sufficient for me. Okay, so these are the 2 cycles. The first one is voltage applied, so it starts from 0, maybe 0.02 is completion of 1 cycle. So this is second cycle. Otherwise, I will show you from first cycle itself. Yeah, yes, I have shown it from 0. So the value is like this. I will clearly show this. Yes, now it is visible. So this is voltage, so it starts from 0, and second one is current. So the current is not starting from 0. Anyhow, let me conclude that, I will give you. And this is my resistance, V, voltage across resistance, and this is voltage across inductance. So this is voltage across resistance and voltage current are in phase to each other, and they have started at this point. And after that, and at this point it will be maximum. This is voltage across inductance. So voltage across inductance is 90 degree ahead of voltage across resistance and also current passing through the circuit. And this is the total voltage, and there is some angle between this voltage and the inductance, maybe resistance voltage, and that voltage is 60 degree. Okay, this is the 60 degree. You can see this is 90. If we cut it into three parts, so this is the second two parts of it, so this is 60 degree. So it starts from 60 degree and this is voltage. So this is the total explanation of the circuit waveform of the series RL circuit when AC supply is given. So let me close this. Yeah, this is the complete explanation of this. We have changed the supply and power GUI to discrete, and resistance, inductance values we have calculated like this. So these are the values. So as this is AC, we need to take the RMS values, as our display block will show only instantaneous values. So we need to see RMS. So we have placed all these RMS values.